साइंस इट्स लाइक मैजिक बट रियल. हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम एमआरती फ्रॉम द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ माइक्रोबायोलॉजी पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट स्टूडेंट. आई वुड लाइक टू एक्सप्रेस सम नॉलेज अबाउट नेशनल साइंस डे. नेशनल साइंस डे इज सेलिब्रेटेड इन इंडिया ऑन 28 फरवरी एवरी ईयर टू मार्क द डिस्कवरी ऑफ रामन इफेक्ट बाय इंडियन फिजिसिस्ट सर सीवी रामन. नेशनल साइंस डे इज सेलिब्रेटेड ऑल ओवर इंडिया इन स्कूल्स, कॉलेजेस, यूनिवर्सिटीज एंड इन रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूशंस. नेशनल साइंस डे इज सेलिब्रेटेड टू स्प्रेड मैसेज अबाउट द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ साइंस यूज्ड इन डेली लाइफ ऑफ एवरी पीपल. ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ नेशनल साइंस डे आई विश टू शेयर सम इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑन रिसर्च ऑन एंटीबैक्टीरियल एक्टिविटी ऑफ पेरगुलारिया डेमिया अगेंस्ट माइक्रोब्स आइसोलेटेड फ्रॉम डेंटल कैरीज. Dental caries or cavity, more commonly known as tooth decay, the most common type of oral disease in humans. It is caused by the breakdown of tooth enamel and characterized by destruction of organic or inorganic parts of the tooth. Microorganisms which are present on the tooth surface usually ferment the carbohydrate which is present in the food we intake, and as a result, they produce some acids which cause demineralization of tooth tissue and initiate dental caries. This results in the formation of cavity on tooth surface. Dental caries is one of the most common disease among children and adults. It is a chronic infection which progresses very slowly in most people. Dental caries also cause bad breath and foul taste. Primary caries can occur on tooth surface which does not possess serious complications, whereas secondary caries can create lesions with pus around the gums. The microbial community present in the caries are mostly facultative and obligate anaerobic bacteria. Some most common genera include Lactobacillus, Eubacterium, Actinomycetes and Bifidobacterium species. It also contains salivarius groups which includes Streptococci, Fusibacterium and Enterococcus species. If you are having cavity, the signs and symptoms may vary according to their damage extent and location. The most common symptom is toothache, and there may be mild to sharp pain whenever you eat or drink something sweet, hot or cold. And there may be presence of brown or black stains on teeth with visible holes on surface. If you have the above said signs and symptoms, your teeth need to be treated to prevent further infection of tooth structure. Early treatment is less painful than treatment of extensive decay. We can treat dental caries by various methods including fluoride treatment, fillings, crowns, root canal, and in severe cases, tooth extractions can be done. Dental caries can be prevented by avoiding sugary foods and drinks which feeds the bacteria in your mouth, and brush regularly with toothpaste which contains fluoride. Fluoride helps to prevent cavities by slowing enamel breakdown. Floss daily after having a meal. It removes food particles in between your teeth. These steps promote healthy teeth as well as healthy gums. Apart from modern system of medicine, traditional system rely heavily on herbal plants. Many herbal plants were reported to inhibit the growth of oral bacteria. Many side effects have been reported in chemical rinses which cause unpleasant taste, tooth discoloration and dryness. Because of that, the use of herbal mouthwashes is increasing nowadays. Numerous herbal plants are of global interest today because of their therapeutic value. According to World Health Organization, approximately 80% of the world's population currently uses herbal medicine. The herbal plant we have chosen is Pergularia damia. It is also called Pergularia extensa. It is a latex, pungent smelling perennial twining herb present on tropical and subtropical regions of India. It is commonly known as Veliparuthi in Tamil and Harikknot in English. In Tamil, the term Veli denotes a guardian or a protector. It is interesting to note that Siddha medicine had named only two medicinal plants which act as a shield for humans. One is Veliparuthi and the another one is Kodiveli. Pergolaria Damia plants can be used as an anti-helminthic, antipyretic and anti-inflammatory agent. Aerial parts of this plant have been hepatoprotective and have anti-diabetic properties. The dried leaves are used in treating bronchitis, asthma, rheumatic fever and so on. Our present study aims at the antibacterial activity of dried leaves of Pergolaria Damia against microbes isolated from dental caries. The samples were collected from volunteers and inoculated on agar plates. After incubation, different colonies were observed. Those colonies were undergone various biochemical tests and two microbes were isolated, Staphylococcus species and Streptococci species. Then the leaf extract of Pergolaria Damia were prepared and the disc were soaked on the extract for a day. Then the disc were placed on agar plates which were inoculated with the Streptococci and the Staphylococci species. The leaf extract showed a great inhibition against dental caries pathogens. The zone of inhibition is measured. From this research, it is concluded that the leaf extract of Pergolaria Damia can be used against the dental caries pathogens. Thank you all. If you like this video, kindly like, share, comment and subscribe to our channel.